Dear students, in this video we are going to learn about shunt, and then we will learn about the conversion of a galvanometer into an ammeter and then into a voltmeter. So to begin with, what is a shunt? A shunt is a low resistance which is connected in parallel with the galvanometer or ammeter so that the strong currents do not destroy the galvanometer and the ammeter. We know that galvanometer is the device which is used to detect the current flowing in any circuit. So suppose you have a galvanometer with you and you have decided to connect that galvanometer in the circuit to detect the current. If the current flowing in the circuit is much more than expected, then don't you think that all of a sudden when the galvanometer will experience a large amount of current flowing through it, then it may get damaged? So to avoid those situations, we use shunt. So shunt is very smartly attached with the galvanometer. Here's the galvanometer. We attach the shunt to the galvanometer by making a parallel combo, a parallel combination. Okay, so here's the galvanometer, you can see. And here's the shunt which is connected in parallel with the galvanometer. Now, intentionally it is done because, as I already told you, that shunt is a low resistance. It's a low resistance. So when it's a low resistance and it's known to you, then don't you think that the current will always follow the low resistance path? The current will always flow through that path which is having pretty less resistance. Okay, so that's how the things go on. Suppose this current is entering in the circuit, so a part of it will flow in the galvanometer and most of it will flow through the shunt. Since this is a parallel combination, so the current entering in the circuit will divide itself. Current will divide itself so that most of it flow through the shunt. Reason? Because it's a low resistance and current follows a low resistance path usually. So what happens? Is flows through it, Ig flows through it, and when they are flowing, and see, galvanometer se Ig current pass ho jayega aur galvanometer damage bhi nahi hoga. And when these currents are moving further, this is Ig going, this is Is coming, they combine at a certain point so that I can be regenerated again. But the fact is, did this galvanometer experience more current? No, it did not. So it's protected from the damage. So let's see how the things are moving. Total current is I. Total current is I. It is divided into two parts, Ig plus Is. So that Is, the current flowing through the shunt, is I minus Ig. Total current minus galvanometer current. Similarly, Ig, the current flowing through the galvanometer, is total current minus the current flowing through the shunt. You have obtained, of course, two equations. Now the resistance of the galvanometer is capital G. If you have two points over here, this point is A and this point is B. If you want to measure the potential difference between these two points, the potential difference between these two points, first of all, I need to tell you what is the meaning of potential difference between any two points. It means how much work you will have to do to carry a unit positive charge from point A to point B. तो potential difference का मतलब होता है कि कौन सा higher potential पे है, कौन सा lower potential पे है, या you samajh lo that if you want to carry a unit positive charge from one point to the other point, then what is the amount of work done? That is potential difference. Anyway, so if you proceed to from A to B through this path, it will be VAB, potential difference between A and B, and of course it is VA minus VB, and potential difference between any two points can be calculated as the current flowing through this path multiplied by resistance of this path. This is Ohm's law. You know that V is equals to IR. Abhi main is path ke through inka potential difference find out karne ka try kar rahi hun. So potential difference ka value hoga current flowing through this path, which is IG, multiplied by resistance of this path. Okay, IG, G. Similarly, if I will calculate potential difference between A and B through this path, same thing is going to happen. Current flowing through this path multiplied by resistance of this path. Current flowing through this path is IS, and the resistance of this path is capital S. So of course, hai to potential difference A or B ka. तो आप किसी भी पाथ से कैलकुलेट करो, इक्वली आएगा. सो दीज टू थिंग्स आर इक्वल. सो व्हाट्स गोइंग टू हैपन नेक्स्ट, लेट अस कीप आई जी जी एज इट इज एंड लेट अस पुट आई एस वैल्यू एज आई माइनस आई जी. द सेम थिंग आई हैव डन ओवर हियर. सॉल्व करो, आई जी का वैल्यू फाइंड आउट करो. ओके, सिमिलरली दिस वॉज द इक्वेशन, central equation where you substituted the value of IS. Now you can do ISS as constant, you can keep it as it is, and you can place the value of IG from here to here, so that ultimately you can find out the value of IS. So you have got the value of galvanometer current, you have got the value of the current flowing through the shunt. So this is how the things actually move. So बेसिकली आपको क्या पता चला, वॉट आर द यूजेज ऑफ शंट? अ शंट इज यूज टू प्रोटेक्ट द गैल्वेनोमीटर फ्रॉम द वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग करंट्स. यस, एंड नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द टू मोर यूजेस. दिस सेम शंट विल बी यूज्ड फॉर कन्वर्टिंग द गैल्वेनोमीटर इनटू एन एमीटर, एंड देन दिस शंट विल बी यूज्ड फॉर इंक्रीजिंग the range of ammeter. So let's start, just give me a second. Okay, so this is ammeter. Let's study how a galvanometer is converted to an ammeter. Point number one, ammeter is that galvanometer only which is a pretty low resistance galvanometer. Ammeter is used to measure the value of the current in the circuit, how much current is flowing in the circuit. And then we study how we carry out this conversion, how we actually convert a galvanometer into an ammeter. To do that, first of all, you need to have a galvanometer, and then you connect the galvanometer with a shunt, a resistance which is connected in parallel, the same theory that I had discussed before. Lekin problem ye hai ki shunt ka value kaise decide karu. Okay, how to decide the value of shunt, what resistance I should use exactly, so that my galvanometer in the picture gets converted to ammeter, right? So I'm going to explain this stuff. First of all, I need to acquaint you with few terms that I'll be using frequently over here. First is capital G, which is the resistance of the galvanometer. Capital G is the resistance of the galvanometer. Then we have small n. What is small n? Number of scale divisions in the galvanometer. Like you have a galvanometer, what are the number of scale divisions in the galvanometer? Okay, next we have capital K. Capital K is figure of merit. व्हाट इज अ फिगर ऑफ मेरिट ऑफ अ गैल्वेनोमीटर? इसका आपके पास एक एक्सपेरिमेंट भी आता है कि आपको फिगर ऑफ मेरिट कैलकुलेट करना है फॉर अ गैल्वेनोमीटर, बट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज फिगर ऑफ मेरिट? फिगर ऑफ मेरिट इज करंट फॉर वन स्केल डिवीजन इन द गैल्वेनोमीटर. यू नो दैट गैल्वेनोमीटर इज अ करंट डिटेक्टिंग डिवाइस. When the current will flow in the circuit, the galvanometer will show deflection. The galvanometer is simply, you know, it works like the odometer of your vehicle, the speedometer. बिल्कुल वैसे ही needle होती है, वो rotate करती है. So when the current actually flows in the circuit, the needle deflects. Figure of merit का मतलब होता है कि एक division से अगर galvanometer deflect करता है, उस वन डिवीजन से डिफ्लेक्ट होने के लिए उसको करंट का कितना रिक्वायरमेंट होगा. दैट इज फिगर ऑफ मेरिट, व्हिच मींस टू डिफ्लेक्ट बाय वन डिवीजन हाउ मच करंट विल बी रिक्वायर्ड बाय अ गैल्वेनोमीटर. नाउ एवरी गैल्वेनोमीटर इज डिजाइंड डिफरेंटली. ओके, सो एवरी गैल्वेनोमीटर हैज a slightly different figure of merit. Okay, so I hope you understand this. Now this is the galvanometer, this is the current flowing. Now you have connected the resistance S in parallel with G. Okay, so what is going to happen? This I current will distribute itself into IG and IS. Now IS is I minus IG. So this is how the things work, as I have explained earlier. If you happen to locate two points here, A and B, so what will be the potential difference between them? The potential difference between them can be looked by two paths, this path and this path. Talking about this path only, the straight one, the potential difference will be equal to current flowing through this path multiplied by resistance of this path. Very simple. Okay, talking about the second path, what will be the potential difference? I minus IG into S. Because the current flowing through this path is I minus IG, resistance is S. Okay, this is the value of VA minus VB, this is the value of VA minus VB. These both values can be equated. For sure they can be. So I have equated them. After that I have calculated the value of shunt. So mujhe shunt ka value pata chal jayega. This much value I should put in. Okay, so what will be the effective resistance of the ammeter? Since this is a parallel combination, so effective resistance of the ammeter, see, this whole stuff is ammeter. This was just galvanometer. I repeat, this whole stuff is ammeter. Okay, and this was only galvanometer. So what is the effective resistance? 1 upon Rp equals to 1 upon G plus 1 upon S, because parallel combo deals as 1 upon Rp equals to 1 upon R1, 1 upon R2, so on. So solve it to find out the total equivalent value of resistance of the ammeter. Now you might be thinking ki bhai kaise ammeter kaise bana. So actually now you can see that this whole device is catching up the overall current. Had it been only a galvanometer, it was recording only IG current corresponding to its resistance. But now connecting a low resistance means most of the current has flown through this low resistance, so that this whole device is covering the overall current capital I. So overall current is measured from it. So this has become an ammeter. I hope you have got it. Now, first of all, if K is a figure of merit, which means current required to produce a unit deflection, okay, and small n be the number of divisions existing in the galvanometer. Earlier, when it was only the galvanometer, and no shunt here, what was the minimum value that a division was recording? It was total current IG, but minimum value that one division was recording is IG upon N. But now, what is the minimum value that this whole device is recording? Capital I upon N. So don't you think that ammeter is recording a larger amount of current as compared to a galvanometer? Of course, yes. That's why galvanometer is never called an ammeter. Galvanometer is converted to an ammeter, where this per division is calculating this much current. So I is of course greater than Ig. So this is how the things work. This is ammeter.